unique life experience I had that helped prepare me for the opportunity to serve on the village board was running a campaign for the last 4 months for the village trustee race. I really enjoyed that opportunity to connect with different community members over those 4 months. I'm also thankful that I got to run against two extremely intelligent and dedicated women who are determined to do a great job to both lead our village and move it forward, and I would love the opportunity to serve our community alongside both of them. The experience of running a campaign gave the community an opportunity to really get to know me over those 4 months. I participated in three different forums. I received many emails from community members in which I responded to every single one. And with that, I also received a lot of telephone calls, and I spent hours talking on the phone to different residents as they wanted to both get to know me, as they wanted to get to know my skill set, and they also wanted to know how I would approach decision making on different issues. I received a lot of emails with community members I'd respond to, and I also met a lot of community members that requested to meet in person, whether it be at coffee shops, inviting people into my home, or often having conversations as I waited for my coffee in the morning and people recognized my photo from the mailers that they received. What was unique about this experience is that it gave the opportunity a chance to really get to know me. And, I'm extremely proud as a first-time candidate how close our race was. And I think it shows that as a community, they had three great people to choose from. And I'm really proud that I was able to connect with that many residents and that they believed in both my leadership skills and my passion for community service to serve our community. Additionally, for my skill set, what I've done is service. That's my background. So I've given back to communities that I care about in different capacities that have kind of matched where I've been at in my life at different periods in time. Working as a domestic violence advocate, I was able to represent a really diverse client base. And that client base, what was so unique about it was that, we had so many different needs, but it was also very similar to managing the functions in which our local government does as well. I worked a lot on housing issues with our clients as they were experiencing domestic violence. I worked a lot with our clients on safety issues. We collaborated closely with law enforcement. We did a lot of financial planning. I was at Sojourner Family Peace Center as we were planning on building the new facilities that is now part of the Family Justice Center, which was a $22 million project. And that was a really exciting time because it was a big transition for us as an organization. And it was allowing us to move forward. We had outgrown our shelter space and housing options for residents. We needed to diversify some of our funding services so that way we could continue to provide more services for our clients and make sure that the services represented what their needs were at the time. And we also wanted to have great facilities for our staff so that way the staff felt like they were working somewhere that they could be proud of and have dignity in the spaces that we expected them to complete their work in. Additionally, I served 3 terms of AmeriCorps service, and what that service taught me was that listening to the individuals of the communities I represent, making sure that their voices had a say at the table, was one of the most important things as I could do as a leader. So I feel like for me, my skill set that I feel confident to serve as a village trustee is based on both my public service experience and the incredible experience I had of running a campaign here in Sherwood for village trustee.